Hey, yo, what's up, everybody? Today we're going to be going over a post that Russ Carson did. His Instagram handle is 81Crowe. He's playing bluegrass banjo backup over a song by Vince Gill called High Lonesome Sound. One of my students asked me to transcribe it, and when I did, I found it was some pretty sick stuff that could be relevant to all sorts of banjo playing, specifically backup and just playing that really like driving bluegrass sound. I'll post the tablature on my Instagram, so if you want to support your boy, sign up there. Other than that, let's get started. Okay, so let's take a look at this tablature. Let's play the first phrase of that. So we're going to be going from measure 1 basically through measure 9. The thing sounds like this. It's a... So that is an excellent example of really just driving backup. And actually, it's a little different than how I play backup, because how I play backup, it's kind of based off I don't know if you guys have got the drive book. Unfortunately, the drive book is actually out of print. One of my students told me that. Very sad times. But I will tend to play this rhythm. And the basic rhythm that he's doing here is a little different. If we take a look at measure 2, he's going like this. It's solid 16th notes as opposed to this roll up. The ba ticka taka ticka ba ticka taka ticka. I call that the Bob Dobelina roll because it's like Bob Dobelina, Mr. Bob Dobelina. But we ain't got time for that right now. But basically, if we're going to analyze this roll, you'll see it's 1, 2, 3, 4, three-note forward rolls. So that's thumb 1-2, thumb 1-2, thumb 1-2, and then thumb 1-2, followed by a square roll, thumb 1, thumb 2. And this can be repeated basically indefinitely. And you'll see not only is this roll repeated on measure 2, it's on... measure 4, measure 6, measure 8. And if you can kind of like browse ahead, here's the roll again on measure 11. Here's the roll again on measure 13, but a slight variation. Let's see, where else? There's the roll again. There's the roll again. And so I have a theory, and I haven't put this into practice, but if you want to learn how to sing and play, if you can play this roll, and you can probably sing at the same time. It sounds super driving, and then Billy Strings will hire you. But something like that, if you could like sing tenor and just have that like. That's an excellent role to have as just kind of one of your like bread and butter backup roles that just drives. I mean, this guy plays with some really like Russ Carson plays with some really heavy cats. You know what I mean? He's like the Southern Festival like bluegrass banjo player. So other than that, that is a huge theme here, and that's the number one takeaway from this analysis is it's 4 forward rolls and then a square roll. Three note thumb forward rolls and then followed by a square roll. And that's actually, I don't know if you guys and been following me for a while, but I had this tune called Alani's Lullaby, and it has this roll in it. And that's actually the same roll. It's four forward rolls, square roll, but it appears on some different strings. But that's a different kind of flavor. Okay, so now let's start going through, now that we kind of understand what that roll is, and that is the probably number one takeaway from this analysis. Let's take a look at some of the specifics here. That little double stop, it's like ba-dum, bum, bum. So what's happening here? We got a double stop followed into forward rolls, and then, yeah, that's a six-note forward roll starting on the offbeat, but what we want here, what you need to train yourself, this is two square rolls right here. This is thumb one, thumb two on a C chord. And then again, we have a thumb one, thumb two on a C chord. So we got thumb one, thumb two, thumb one, thumb two. And so you'll begin to feel that, because a lot of what this guy builds with is forward rolls, square rolls, and then a few forward backward rolls. That's almost the entirety of this thing. And it makes for excellent, excellent bluegrass banjo backup. So that measure. I mean, this thing. That's these two beats right here. You want that to feel very natural. These square rolls, these thumb one, thumb twos, should come off very naturally, and you'll be able to put them in. I mean, because they're perfectly a beat in length. So yeah, and then you couple that with this measure, and you have basically like the theme for the whole song. That's a great sound. It's a great sounding backup. That's excellent, excellent backup. And so then you have this guy, which is those same two beats again. Those two square rolls over the C chord. Thumb one, thumb two, thumb one, thumb two. Again. And then we have this guy, which is a two beat forward backward roll. And then back into that roll. So. But he does a slide there. So you can see that these square rolls are going to come in handy, and then here we got the forward back roll coming on that. That's kind of... And yeah, I tend to see this as a single piece. I always talk about this, and this is probably the most important thing I've ever discovered in my whole banjo world. But the forward backward roll, this the first beat right there, that is a four note thumb forward roll. It starts on the thumb and it follows through with a forward roll for four beats, or four notes. I talk about that in, I think, Modes of Rhythm and a handful of stuff, but just understand that's a four-note thumb forward. This is a four-note middle reverse. If you delete that, it'll be a little more clear, but that is a middle reverse roll. I don't like writing in the slides and pull-offs because it's too busy for me. I just kind of can see that and just kind of assume it's a pull-off. Four-backward roll, that's a four-note thumb forward, and then a four-note middle reverse. We say middle reverse because it starts on the middle. We say thumb forward because it starts on the thumb. Okay, cool. And then we have this guy. Let's see what that is. Okay, this measure is a little complicated. Basically, what happens here is he's playing don't you do this to me. He's playing the same roll, right? Except he has to deviate right there because he needs to get onto a double square roll right there. So this roll is kind of an exception, and this kind of thing can be improvised. But the goal here is to land with a thumb on the downbeat for that double square roll. So this is where it actually, those two notes, is where it actually has to escape the forward roll in order to make that happen. So I hope that makes sense. And then this guy again. Duh. Okay, so here's a hot lick right here. So measure eight lands into that standard that forward roll ending with the square roll. Here, what is this? Okay, so first thing that I see immediately, and this is how you guys should start to see this this whole eight note group. That's a forward backward roll. Sorry, that is a forward backward roll. It's the same roll as this one, and you start to see the shapes. Again, right here, that's a four-note thumb forward. This is a four-note middle reverse. And the notes are F, but the roll is still the same. And then here, again, the first thing I see, square roll. Right here, I see square roll, thumb one, thumb two. Again, you have to assume that it's pull-offs a hammer on to pull off. But again, I mean, how this guy is playing rhythm, for me, it's very clearly divided into four note groupings. Bukatika, bakatika, bukatika, bakatika, bukatika, bakatika, duh. So I just kind of see the rolls, and it makes a lot of sense, and it sounds driving, it sounds good. So anyways, it's a four back roll over an F chord. Again, we have that square roll over the C chord. And then here we got this little fancy thing, which is actually just a square roll. But we're going. And then we land back into the theme. So I hope that makes sense. Just see it as four note groups. Forward backward roll, which is thumb forward, middle reverse. Then we got square roll and then a square roll. Hold on. Okay. So, and then, so after the theme, and then here, that's going, like, when he goes right into the top of the verse right there. Okay, so that being said, play the second half. I mean, well, I don't know if this guy needs any explanation. One thing that I'm paying attention to, this right here, that is all, that's a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 note forward roll. This little section right here is kind of like a forward-backward roll. If I was open. Forward-backward roll makes it sound good. And then really you're aiming for that note right there. That's where like, right on the downbeat, everybody can smack that together. And then you get to this guy right here. And that's where the singer starts. So that's a really important one to nail. Okay, cool. So now let's play the second half. So now we're basically gonna play. What happened here? What happened to my order? See, sometimes this program just messes up. Okay, so now we're gonna start from here, play all the way there. Okay. So what does this sound like? It's gonna be like. Messed up right there. This is actually should not be in there. Okay, so what is happening here? So what happens here? So basically it's the same thing. These two measures are the same as these two measures because we're playing backup. That kind of thing can be repeated pretty easily. What happens here? There he has a little eighth note pause to emphasize the four chord. So as long as you understand square roll, and then you got that eighth note pause. And then you got a little four backward roll right there. That shouldn't be too difficult. Okay, cool. So this measure 13 is actually pretty sweet. Because what's happening there is it's the same roll as the theme. Remember, it's 1, 2, 3, 4 forward rolls and then a square roll. So that guy's 1, 2, 3, 4. This one looks a little disguised because of the hammer-on, but make no mistake, that is a forward roll. And then this guy looks a little disguised because it's not exactly on the same strings as it was before, like, say, over here. But this one is, in fact, a square roll. So at this measure... same role as the theme, and I can see this being very easily improvised and given that nice like minor pentatonic bluesy driving banjo sound that we all want to, you know, have control of. That's a sweet measure, that measure 13. Definitely practice that one. Okay, now what's happening here? Again, we already talked about this measure. It's the same as Measure 5, the same roll. He deviates outside of the square roll, or outside of the forward roll, to land in a double square. Cool. And then this guy is kind of, this is a lick. Okay, cool. I mean, that's just, he's got a pinch, and then square roll right on the downbeat. Yeah, and this guy, that's actually thumb one. As long as it's just, I would think about it as this forward roll with a pickup. So it's this with this. It's with that as a pickup. Yeah, this with a two-note pickup. That's how I would think about it. So this one's a lick. It's sweet. It's four beats long. Okay, now we get this measure 16. So that guy is sweet. Okay, this is a new technique we haven't really discussed. I learned this at Banjo Camp from Kristen Scott Benson. This is, again, the forward-backward roll on F. But what happens if you look at the first string, first there's a 3 and then there's a 0. What Kristen Scott Benson called it, and I actually really love the term, she calls it a tailored reversal. And so what that means, in the forward-backward roll, roll reverses, you basically change the note on one string. In that case, it's the first string. And if you're not playing this, you're going. So you're tailoring the reversal. Not keeping that F note twice. We don't want that. That's what we want. Okay, cool. It's a tailored reversal of an F chord. And then we have this thing. It starts with a square roll. And that's just some J.D. Crowe stuff. Kind of a. That's really important to get. This is an awesome lick going into C. I think he actually makes a mistake there if you listen really closely, because what kind of happens are kind of messes up. But this is what I think he meant to play, and I actually like the sound of this a little more. So let's see. Basically, I like... this is the important part of the roll. That's basically like a G, like a suspended G7. The first four notes, that is a square roll, kind of like a G7. Right here, that's just a forward roll, landing on the eighth note of C. And then this guy is probably the hard part, but it's still a square roll. And let's see what this is. That's kind of like a forward backer kind of thing. Yeah, if you can do that, if you guys have gotten this far, you could probably play that lick. And I think we already went over that somewhere in here with a forward backer roll. It's like a five note forward backer roll, this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, that's a great, great lick going to a C chord. And you should learn that one. Okay, cool. And then what happens here? Now he starts getting fancy. So yeah, he's repeating licks. This thing, I don't know, this measure that I've highlighted. When you're navigating this stuff, just read the rhythm. That's an eighth note. And then 1, 2, 3 forward rolls. And then lands on the downbeat of 4. You could probably throw something like this in there. I don't know if he does it, but something like that. So it's but I didn't write that in, so he probably didn't do it. And then this measure, which is kind of fancy. It's just like a rhythmic thing, but understand it's a square roll. Last four beats is a square roll with a two note pickup. And then measure 20 is, again, that's we played that measure a few times. Back to theme. Okay, and then what's happening here? This, Yeah, that's so this is actually forward backward roll right there. You can kind of see that thumb one. It's a thumb forward, then a middle reverse. Just keep your eye on that. And then two square rolls. And then the last measure, it's a forward backward roll on F. And then it kind of, and then it ends because it's only a minute. So the key takeaways, definitely this measure. And just being able to read rolls. Thanks so much for listening, guys. I'll post this on the Patreon. Thanks for your support. Thanks for watching. And keep in touch. Peace out.